Jax NAS 2014. Yeah.
Back home again.
The right wing, the right knife bed rehearsal. Flying upside down.
I wonder why.
The slider. And another forward flip. At 100 miles per hour.
Listen to the sound of that motor.
This is a big airplane. Melissa's airplane, about 1,300 pounds. This, watch Gene Soucy, a gentleman who has more awards and accolades than any other current active air show performer. For showmanship with the International Council of Air Show Sort of Excellence. This is the Showcat. Four continents. And perhaps his most outstanding performance came with his event. 25 years. The Showcat. He's going to come down the line. Give him a wave as he does.
National Guard, that makes us a state of the art, man.
America. It's got a 2,000 horsepower Pratt and Whitney radial engine on the front and a huge propeller to absorb that horsepower and give it speeds in excess of 425 miles per hour. They bent the wing down so that they could get a landing gear short enough, or I should say long enough and strong enough, yet light enough to keep... The Corsair first flew in 1940 and was designed, oh, John Platt coming by, give him a wave as he taxis by. The Corsair was initially designed to be flown off the decks of aircraft carriers, but that huge engine and a fuel tank behind it put the pilot way back in the fuselage and caused visibility problems. And assigned to land-based units in the Pacific, serving with the Marine Corps, where it saw extensive... There's one particular squadron in the Marine Corps that really gained a lot of fame because of their leader, a gentleman who actually wound up with 28 aerial victories in the Corsair, part of that 11-to-1 victory ratio against the Japanese Zeros in air combat in the Pacific. And his name was Greg Pappy Boyington, VMA 214, known as the Black Sheep Squadron. That was attached to some of the Corsairs that were built. Saw a very, very long... Gene Soucy coming down the line give him a wave as he comes by. Way to go, Gino, Mr. Air Show. Give him a round of applause, everybody. And again, from the right, here comes the Corsair. After the barrel roll, the four-point hesitation roll, let's see what he's got next. Were so famous that back in 1976 to 1978, there was a television show about
who had lost
the Corsair, fully loaded, weighed about 7 tons, with a wingspan of 41 feet, a length of 33 and a half feet, and a height from the bottom of the tires to the top of the tail of just 15 feet 1 inch. The 12,571 Corsairs stayed in production longer than any other single-engine piston aircraft ever built in the military, from 1940 to nearly 1953, when the last one came off the Volk production line for the French Air Force. It even saw service in Korea. Warburg Museum in Titusville. For Skyhawk 2, this time in the carrier configuration pass. As it made its ground attacks on Japanese positions on islands in the Pacific, the F-4U Corsair would make an incredible whistle as the air flowed through the oil coolers. Look how far back the pilot sits. That was a very, very big challenge. Forth a little bit on the runway, kind of snaking back and forth. It's that visibility over the nose problem that he is handling by pushing on the right rudder pedal and looking out to the left. Then he pushes on the left rudder pedal and looks out to the right to keep himself pretty much centered on the taxiway.
Thank you.
is not having any lift generated by the wings. 400 horsepower. So new and beefed up aerodynamically that though it looks old, it doesn't perform like an old airplane. It performs like a high-performance hot rod.
We're going to see maximum life and maximum performance. No matter what you fly, Aircraft Specialty Services has a product or service.
Looks like a 1930s racer, a 1930s cabin class biplane, but it is really, really current in terms of its performance. Talk about street rod. Look at that.
30-year-old Melissa Pemberton, the youngest woman ever to win a spot on the United States aerobatic team in international competition, and a world champion base jumper. She's into extreme sports. It's on the lift. Let's watch the P-51. Listen to it as Lee Lauderback, the highest time Mustang pilot in the world, takes off and rolls his Mustang 360 degrees on takeoff.
In the world today, your United States Air Force F-22 Raptor. Folks, if you've ever wanted to know where your bombs and missiles hide, here's the answer.
Power loop.
many jets can climb fast, but not many jets can slide. Ladies and gentlemen, from the right, the Raptors, slow speed class.
In the F4U Corsair, Patty Wagstaff, give them a wave. She's going back to St. Augustine, and in just a moment, we'll be bringing Otto the helicopter out for his performance for you today. Here, Dave used to fly A4 Skyhawk 2s right from here at NAS Jacksonville, and when he arrived on Thursday with the airplane to get set up, it was the first time he had flown a Navy jet to this airfield in over 40 years. It was quite a homecoming for Dave Dollarhide. Now let's watch as Dan McCue and Patty Wagstaff run him up. Two very dissimilar aircraft in a formation takeoff.
The Raptor pulled it off. You are hovering, working all five flight controls, collective throttle, pedals, and sight link. But can you hover and chew gum and blow a bubble at the same time? All right, well, let her ring. Roger, and I would like to dedicate today's show to Planthead, Mr. Bill Meyer. a phenomenal aviator here at NAS Jacks. We've done many, many shows with him, and Roger and Phil Flashman Meyer even played a game of golf or two down at Sun and Fun with their helicopters, of course. All right, Otto, that was magnanimous, but I tell you what, buddy, you cheated. You were using a balloon. You better fess up and tell the truth, buddy. All right, well, I do commend your honesty. All right, we've got to work directly beneath the aircraft. Nice twirl. Nice job, Otto. Give it up for him, ladies and gentlemen. I can't work a yo-yo on the ground, and he's doing it up in the air. Look at that. He nailed it. Otto, I got another contest for you now, buddy. Do you think you could race around those barrels faster than a rodeo horse? The record time for a rodeo horse is 14 seconds. There's a 5-second limit while locked down a barrel. Ready, set, go.
Wild west.
And now the first barrel, nice tight turn. This user is called a turn about a point and ball pilot for that, which is the most puff and smoke as you go, and a stop light homing HIO. The helicopter has been called the horse of the modern day aircraft. Oh no, barrel down. Go down, go take a closer look and not get over. Oh look, think for yourself. I told you so. You would have had it, but you know. Hey, there's a 6-inch hole in the back of that back at the pilot. All right, that's some pretty fancy footwork there, buddy. I hope it doesn't get stuck on your skin shoes. Now bring it on down. We're coursing around, literally.
Teresa Stokes is wing walking, ladies and gentlemen. Give her Team Soucy flew for you earlier here in the Showcat. A remarkable aerobatic demonstration in this very heavy, Grumman, highly modified AdCat that is now known as the Showcat. And now, noted, internationally known aviation artist, Teresa Stokes, also a very talented pilot in her own right, is now riding on the wing of the Showcat. There are flying wires that keep the upper and lower wings together. They cross midway between the wings, go through a piece of wood called a javelin strut. She is holding on to that strut right now. About 3 feet long, about 2 inches in diameter. Wires and no parachute on top of the wing. She's waving at you, Jax. You know what to do. She's going to reach around and pull a lap belt around her to hold her in position, because Jean Soucy, if you recall, did lose. Got totally aerobatic. He's going to do the same thing with Teresa Stokes on the wing right now. This is an awesome and challenging thing for Teresa, because unlike Jean, who's in the cockpit, strapped in with a windscreen, she is being pummeled by 100 plus mile an hour winds and still able to hold her arms out. She's not traveling across America, dazzling audiences. She lives in Houston, Texas, near the Johnson Space Center on her houseboat studio. The speed picks up. Speed picks up now past 110, 120, 130, 140 miles. From 4Gs to weightless. Teresa Stokes has a big share of the airplane you see before her because she designed the paint scheme of the Showcat. She's a pilot with over 1,500 flying hours. She's the official artist for the International Council of Air Show's annual Hall of Fame portrait plaques. And in 1997, watch this roll. Stopping at every 90 degrees, her body gets whipped very, very violently. Teresa, along with her partner Gene, won the Bill Barber Award for Showmanship, given by World Air Show News at the Experimental Aircraft Association's fly-in called Air Venture at Oshkosh, Wisconsin. Wires as they go from the 4-point hesitation roll this time to the 8-point hesitation roll, stopping every 45 degrees of rotation. Knife edge 45 and completing the 8-point hesitation roll. This is called the side saddle. Now, in a spin that is diving him earthward at over 4,000 feet per minute, I want you to welcome from Salinas, California, the award-winning Sean D. Tucker in the Oracle Challenger 3. That's called the centrifuge. Sean does one of his newest maneuvers. He'll dive down to the left-hand side and set up for that new maneuver. But look at the roll rate of this amazing, a dizzying routine that would make you and me lose our lunch. Sean D. Tucker, now at 1,000 feet, does the forward flip. He'll recover inverted, setting up for his next maneuver, which is known as the Hooey Loop. It's an inside-outside loop with a tumble at the top. He's pulling positive G's. The airplane now goes tumbling out of control as he reaches show center. He'll experience... to the left. It'll do a shoulder roll to the right as he loses airspeed and gravity takes over. He will now kick hard on the left rudder pedal to do not one, but two consecutive hammerhead stall turns. This aircraft is the Oracle Challenger 3. It was custom built specifically for Sean by his team because his other aircraft was unable to keep up with what he wanted to do. Sean D. Tucker inspired a new generation of radio-controlled model pilots. And with their new aircraft and their control and power and lightweight aircraft, they could do things that fixed-wing, full-size fixed-wing airplanes couldn't do. They inspired Sean D. Tucker to do things that no full-scale airplane pilot has ever done. Check this. He's upside down and he's sliding sideways. This is called the Frisbee Turn. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to go live to the cockpit and say hello to Sean D. Tucker. Sean D. Tucker, are you with us?
I am with you, Rob. Ladies and gentlemen, say together the three best words. That's right, in the language, English language. The magic of flight. So we're at this Navy base. You see a man and woman in the uniform. You give a kiss. You give it a hug. I'm in reverse. And you tell them thanks for sharing their base and protecting our freedom. All right, Rob, I got work to do. Let's go.
He's going to dive down to those ribbons that you saw being walked out to the runway. He's going to check them out as he dives under ribbon number one and under ribbon number two. They're spaced 700 feet apart. They are 40 feet between each pole. 18 feet high, and between each of those poles is a ribbon. Now, the smoke is off. He's going to dive down. Accelerate to 215 miles per hour in a dive and level out. Let's take a look. Cameras on as Sean D. Tucker approaches ribbon number one. He goes through it, right knife edge through ribbon number one. Left knife edge through ribbon number two. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the unbelievable and impressive Sean D. Tucker.